Goedemorgen, mijn Vlaamse mensen. Ik ben heel trots om hier te zijn, als halve Vlaming, op een dak in Marokko. Bonjour tout le monde, on est ici à Rabat. On est très ravis d'être ici et partager la musique namibienne et européenne à Visa for Music. Shishani, I'm a vocalist, guitar player. Together we are Namibian Tales, and I'll just pass the mic for every musician to introduce themselves.
My name is Debby. I play mbira, kora, and I sing.
Sjahin During, percussions.
My name is Bence Huzar, and I play the cello.
A couple of years ago, I met Sjahin. It's now, I think, 3 years ago. And he basically approached me saying, I like what you do, I like your songwriting, and you're in Namibia a lot and you're doing all this research about Namibia and Namibian music, but I don't hear those influences in your music, because I was playing mainly songs inspired by soul music, by let's say Afro-American styles. That's the music that I grew up to, because I grew up in the Netherlands. And so he decided to say, okay, let's you know, try to make a project based on the musical traditions from Namibia. And he knew Bence already from a previous project that he had worked with, and we were desperately looking high and low for a kora player to join our group. And we worked with different people. And we actually approached Debby to help us find a kora player, but we didn't know that she played kora herself. And this is how actually the band came together. We did some tryouts, some jams, and this is how we continued. It's a West African instrument, but it's more the colors that we were looking for in the group. So we wanted to make a project that is not necessarily traditional music, but it's very much, you know, interpretations, personal touch, and you know, just looking for sounds that are beautiful and also quite unique together.
We play together for about 2 years now, so 1 year we were searching, trying out, and then we started our first concert about 2 years ago. So we were just in China, Jordania, we might go to Korea, now in Morocco, Germany, Vienna almost, and Switzerland we went. So it's going very well, actually.
And you're forgetting a very important place.
Namibia.
Yeah.
Yes, and but for a new group, it's going. We are very happy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So I was born in Windhoek, Namibia's capital city. I have a Namibian mother, a Flemish father that moved to South Africa in the 80s and then moved further up to Namibia a few years later. And then when I was about 5 years old, we all moved to the Netherlands. My dad got a job there. So I basically spent my youth in the Netherlands, grew up there, did my schooling there, but you know, always traveled back for vacations, always kept, you know, the contact between these two places. So also going back to Belgium, to the family over there, going back to Namibia, but living in the Netherlands. It was very tough. There was no access to Namibian music. So there, you couldn't find anything. And then when I was about 16, I found the first and only CD from Namibia. And it was like an ethnographic recording of songs of the Junglasi San people. And this fascinated me, of course. And this was also like a little piece from home, because you're always looking for this sense of identity, for a way to connect. And because I was always making music since I was 4 years old. So you just grow up with, let's say, urban styles. So this was my musical school. Until actually we started this project, Namibian Tales, where it was like really diving into, you know, researching these traditions, going to visit the people, recording the music with the people, learning the stories, you know, and it was, let's say, a lovely push to go into that part of let's say, my Namibian roots. So the first album was more personal stories. I was asking a lot of family members, like, okay, what is our family about? What is our family story? What happened in the country? So tried to incorporate that into the first album. And then the second album, Kalahari Encounters, is where we, you know, traveled to a little village in the Kalahari Desert and worked with these grandmothers and basically recorded their songs and then rearranged their songs, you know, gave our own twist to it. So we went there in November 2016, recorded some music, went back to Amsterdam, 6 months of arranging and composing, and then we returned in June, where we then, you know, rehearsed for 10 days, gave 3 concerts, recorded 2 of those concerts, and that is the live album that we brought out September this year. The beautiful thing is, of course, that we're here and everybody's from a different place on the planet. And now we're in Rabat, you know, at Visa for Music. So what I think is beautiful also about this event, the focus on what they say, world music, it's really a way to celebrate the diversity of all these different cultures. Because as I said, we don't do traditional Namibian music. We use the elements, we're inspired by it, we create our own sound through incorporating West African instruments from Zimbabwe as well, the mbira. We have Bence with his classical cello background and creating new sounds, experimenting with you know, soundscapes. The percussion setup is also inspired from instruments from all over the world, Afro-Cuban music traditions, Indian instruments, kanjira. So in a way, we want to, let's say, celebrate and honor these musical traditions from Namibia, but we're really also trying to just create a new music, our own sound in a way. And it's wonderful that people are reacting so positively to it, and that we're, you know, we're able to travel and you know, make more music and share this music.
Doing a little woo-woo on the roof.
Woo-woo?
Woo-woo.
Oh! Yeah, get ho, 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 ho,